VW here. Thank you for tuning in. It is Tuesday, Tutorial Tuesday, episode 10. Yes. And you ever get one of those days where you just don't feel like crocheting? Well, yeah, that's today. I don't feel like crocheting, you guys. But because I love you so much, I wanted to bring you something. So this has been requested so many times. And so I finally decided to go ahead and do this tutorial, okay? And it is on lettering. Yes, I know some of you have been waiting and waiting. So I finally decided to go ahead and do it. But I'm not crocheting. I'll show you what I do before I actually put it onto my project, all right? So what you will need is graph paper, or you can use lined paper. That's how I first started out, on lined paper, but graph paper works good because you use the squares as your stitch, okay? And I'm going to use like a red marker so you guys can see it real good. I'm sorry, you guys. I just woke up today and I just did not feel like doing any crocheting. Plus, I just got home from the gym and I really did not feel like crocheting. So, sorry. And excuse my hair. I took those twists out and washed it. And so, this is the results, what you're looking at. I missed my twist, so I'm going to put them back in right after this tutorial. So, yes. So, if you're ready, get your marker and your graph paper. So I'll show you how to do the lettering. And I'm going to do the whole alphabet, but not all in this tutorial. I'll do A, B, and C today. And so the next tutorial, if I don't do something else, I'll do 3 or 4 more letters. But you can request particular letter you want me to work on, okay? But this is to generally give you the idea of how to do your lettering. So you probably can play with it a little bit and get your own style, okay? But this is just the basic and plain way, okay? So get ready, let's go. Okay, so I'm gonna show you guys what I do before I do my crochet lettering. I do everything on paper first. So I kinda lined everything up. I'm doing a visor, and so the visor is 12 rows, so I mark 12 lines out, all right, here. And then I kind of just made a rectangle, all right, and did the same thing on this side. So I'm going to show you how I do my A and B and C. And I'll go through the whole alphabet, but on different tutorials, I'll do about 3 to maybe 4 letters per tutorial. But I'm going to kind of spread them out because I may do something else for next tutorial. All right. And if you have a particular group of letters that you want me to do, send me a message. All right, so I'm going to show you how I do my A. All right, and my letters are going to be 7 squares long, and this is graph paper. This is what I use to do my letters. You can use this on regular line paper, but I prefer to do it on graph paper. Okay, so my letters are going to be 7 squares high and 6 squares as far as width. All right, so this is 12, so I'm going to count 2 up, and I'm going to start at the 3rd from the bottom. All right, and then I'm going to start the bottom part of my A. Okay, so I'm going to do a mark here, and just think of this X as a single crochet. I did 2 marks there. I'm going to skip for the middle of the A and do 2 more, and then I want to do this 4 more times on each side. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, and do it over here. All right, and then 4. So now I want to do the top part of my A for it to angle out a little bit. So I'm going to skip over and do 1 here, 1 in the middle, and 1 on top of there. And then I'm just going to repeat that right there, right there, right there. All right. And then this is an A. And so you can put your crossover anywhere. I chose to put it right there.
All right. And this is seven squares high. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we're kind of put where the lettering shouldn't be. Okay. So now I'm going to skip two for a space. Or you could skip one. Normally I skip one, but I'm going to skip two so you can better see this. All right. Now I'm going to show you how to do a B. All right. And I'm going to start with the first part, the downward part. So we're going to put an X here and one there. And then we're going to do this five more times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right. And then we're going to do it one more time, actually. So a total of six times. Okay. So now we want to do the curving part. So now you just want to, I'm going to start here. And I'm just going to add three extra X's. 1, 2, 3. Just like that. Okay. And so then I'm going to move out one. And put one here, and then one right next to it, there. And I'm going to do it again. And that's for the, it's starting to round a little bit. So now I want to bring it in. So I'm going to skip over and come down and bring it in together like that. So then I want to repeat what I did here, down here. So I'm going to skip out right here. There it is. So now I want to do the last part. And you want to just do three X's across. So 1, 2, 3. And you probably have to play with it for a minute to you can get it the way you want it. So as you can see, that is a B. And so you would change your colors here. This is the color of what your hat or visor or whatever was going to be. And then the red is to determine the color of your lettering. All right, so that was the B. Now we'll show you a C. So we're gonna skip two, 1, 2, and we're gonna start our C. Now to start our C, we're gonna skip one more and do four going across. 1, 2, 3, and 4. All right. That's the C part. And then you want to skip up one to the side, if you can see, and mark it there. All right. So now you want to do this curve part here. So you want to do this five times. Okay. So we're going to put an X right above the first one and then move it out and do it four more times. 1, 2, 3, 4. All right. Now we want to curve it here for the C. So we're just going to do it four X's. One above that one. 2, 3, and 4. Halo, stop. Sorry, you guys, my cat. Okay, so now we're going to do an X right underneath the last one. So there's your curve. So there's your C. So A, B, and C. That's how you do it. Around one of these days, I'm not quite sure. Maybe I'll show you guys how to do an A or something, how I actually crochet it. But I'm just not really in the mood to crochet today. So sorry about that, guys, but I thought I'd just show you what I do. So this is what I do before I start my project. So hope that helped for some of you out there. You need to get graph paper. Line paper will work, but I prefer graph paper. So thanks for tuning in. Hopefully the next tutorial will be maybe some letters that you would like me to do. So send me a message on the letters you want to do. I'll only do about 3 or 4 letters at a time. So just let me know. All right. Take care, you guys. Love you. God bless.
So yes, hopefully this tutorial worked out on your lettering. I hope so. I hope it was easy. I tried to do the easiest route I could. So hopefully that worked. And so if you want to try different letters, go ahead. Just, I gave you the general idea of what to do. So thanks for tuning in for this tutorial. I hope the lettering helped. So hopefully I'll be seeing you guys with your visor or hat or purse or whatever you want to put your lettering on. So, and once we get all the alphabets done, then we'll start going into designs, okay? Because this is what I use to do my designs as well. So, yeah. So thanks for tuning in. Hope that helped. Remember, send me a message if you have a request on the lettering. So see you next time. God bless. Bye. 1 Thessalonians chapter 1, verses 2 and 3. We give thanks to God always for you all, making mention of you in our prayers, remembering without ceasing your work of faith and labor of love and patience of hope in our Lord Jesus Christ in the sight of God and our Father.